My competitive edge is being able to create motion or movement with my teams to inspire them to achieve more than they believe is possible. What I've learned in my career is that to do this, you have to first truly understand and honestly acknowledge where people are before you can ask them to either accelerate or choose a different path. If you don't take a chance, you'll never know. Well, one way to do this, which sounds very simple, is by consistently communicating the meaning of what we do and why we do it. When we're very intentional about what is truly meaningful and letting that be the powerful force that drives our decisions, we can create environments where people don't just survive, but they actually thrive. As with everything in life, when people are truly able to attach a meaning to something, whether it be a project, an event, or a celebration, that meaning is always accompanied by a feeling. And people are motivated when they feel something, not just when you tell them to do something. So when each and every person on the team feels that they have a meaningful impact, the output and actions are really significant. And once a team is in motion towards that goal, it's about creating an environment that is safe to elevate and to question, and also give them the resources they need to be successful in that new place. When I started at Biogen, my most senior leaders were 75% male and only 25% female. Through a lot of hard work and time, we achieved our goal of at least 50% women and men from mid to senior leaders. We have more work to do, but we're making progress because we are grounded in a shared understanding of the impact it will have on our employees, our customers, and ultimately our patients when we achieve our vision. So what you waiting on? Who you waiting for? If you don't take a chance, you'll never know. The negative voice in our head can creep in and convince us either you're not good enough, you won't be liked, or you don't have the skills you need. You know, I was a diver in college, and it was really good training for deflecting that negative self-talk because it's a dangerous sport. So if you let that negative talk take over, you can actually really hurt yourself. And I remember one championship meet in college. I was winning through the first few rounds, and then I failed a dive, which is extremely unusual at that level of competition. And it was in front of my family, my friends, and other competitors who I'd been competing with for several years. And I mean, I was ashamed and I was also mortified. And in that moment, I had a choice. I could continue on that path and keep beating myself up for what just happened, or I could try to block it out and focus on what was ahead of me. Either way, I had to get back up on that diving board. And both of those choices would have had very different outcomes. However, I chose to block out the negative voice, and I ended up barely winning that competition by only a tenth of a point. The voice in our head can be the loudest one, but we need to train ourselves to resist the impulse to listen when it's so critical. If we quiet that voice, we can find the focus we need during challenging situations and direct our energy to the people and the opportunities that are in front of us.